"We have taken the unprecedented step of stripping her of the city's highest honor because of her inaction in the face of oppression." Aung San Suu Kyi smiles after receiving an honorary degree at Oxford University in 2012. Reuters: Aung San Suu Kyi has been stripped of the honor granting her the freedom of the city of Oxford because of her weak response to the Rohingya crisis. Oxford city councillors agreed they did not want to honor those who turn a blind eye to violence. The de facto leader of Burma, an Oxford graduate, was granted freedom of the city in 1997 for her long struggle for democracy after spending years under house arrest in Rangoon while she fought for democracy in her homeland of Burma, also known as Myanmar. A cross-party motion was unanimously supported at a special county council meeting in Oxford Town Hall. CRLL Mary Clarkson, who proposed the motion, said when Aung San Suu Kyi was given the freedom of the city in 1997 it was because she reflected Oxford's tolerance and internationalism. "We celebrated her for her opposition to oppression and military rule in Burma. Today we have taken the unprecedented step of stripping her of the city's highest honor because of her inaction in the face of oppression of the minority Rohingya population." Oxford City Council votes unanimously to remove freedom of the city from Aung San Suu Kyi. Councillors say with heavy hearts and regret. Rohingya Myanmar picked out. Twitter.com excurge 5 shoe. Barnaby Phillips at Barnaby Phillips. November 27, 2017. She added that the reputation of the city was being tarnished by honoring those who turn a blind eye to violence. Ms. Suu Kyi studied PPE politics, philosophy and economics at St. Hugh's College in Oxford, graduating with a third-class degree in 1967. There have been calls for her to be stripped of the Nobel Peace Prize she was awarded in 1990 following her response to the Rohingya crisis. The UN has called the current violence against the Muslim Rohingya minority in the Buddhist country a textbook example of genocide. An estimated 600,000 Rohingya have been forced to flee horrific violence and the burning of their villages to neighboring Bangladesh, but Ms. Suu Kyi has dismissed claims of ethnic cleansing and called the multiple accounts of UAL violence used against Rohingya women fake rape. Pope Francis has tonight arrived in Burma under mounting pressure to address the crisis directly by calling the Rohingya by that name. Inside the country, the use of the word is contentious, and the Rohingya are referred to by the majority population as Bengalis. More about Burma Rohingya crisis. Aung San Suu Kyi. Oxford: reuse content. We use cookies to enhance your visit to our site and to bring you advertisements that might interest you. Read our privacy and cookie policies to find out more. We've noticed that you are using an ad blocker. Advertising helps fund our journalism and keep it truly independent. It helps to build our international editorial team, from war correspondents to investigative reporters, commentators to critics. Click here to view instructions on how to disable your ad blocker and help us to keep providing you with free-thinking journalism for free. Thank you for your support. How to disable your ad blocker for independent.co.uk. Adblock. Adblock Plus. Click the Adblock Plus icon, which is to the right of your address bar. On Adblock, click Don't Run on Pages on this domain. On Adblock Plus, click Enabled on this site to disable ad blocking for the current website you are on. If you are in Firefox, click Disable on independent.co.uk. Firefox tracking protection if you are private browsing. In Firefox, tracking protection may cause the ad block notice to show. It can be temporarily disabled by clicking the shield icon in the address bar. Ghostery. Click the Ghostery icon. In versions before 6.0, click Whitelist site. In version 6.0, click Trust site or add independent.co.uk to your trusted site list. In versions before 6.0, you will see the message site is whitelisted. Click Reload the page to see your changes. U-block. Click the U-block icon. Then click the big power button to whitelist the current website, and its state will be remembered next time you visit the website. Then reload the page. Thank you for supporting independent.co.uk.